the concept of...
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Ms. Shakufa. My name is Fatima Ayed. In fact, Fatima Ayed. I would love to apologize myself from all of you. Please allow me to apologize for all of them with a sincere apology that I had something to do and still unfinished. But let me give my point in right. And I really hope that you you forgive me for this. As in this first, as in this day of Women's Day, I would love to salute all the ladies in the floor. And sorry for being late. And I really hope peace would spread, health and wealth for all. To join this, yeah.
Say. Fatima, excuse me, we cannot hear you properly. Are you in some sort
because
of noisy?
That's why, yes, that's why, my dear, I'm telling you, I'm so much in doing my best to get this done. Okay, can you hear me right now?
Now it's a little bit better than before. Yeah, please carry on.
Yeah, wallah, sorry, but I'm not in Kuwait right now. That's why, my dear, first of all, sorry for being late, okay? And I really apologize for all the ladies in the panel and in the floor. And my best salute, my best wishes for all ladies around the globe in this day. There is so much to do from my perspective, I guess, for ladies in humanitarian act and to advocate for their own rights. The thing is about Kashmir, I always connect Kashmir to the conflict around the world, say Palestine or call it any, give it any name, Palestine, Iraq and Kuwait, anywhere where there is a geographical constraint, like between India and Pakistan, there is always a that cannot be resolved, from my perspective at least, cannot be resolved unless there is a political will. We had said this along and alongside with the other meeting, but I think it's time for not only women, but for children, women, all public, okay, to have a public movement against this. And this should move the government in a governmental level to look at the problem and their suffering, because unfortunately in this world only media can talk, okay, and maybe half media in your place can say the truth. As for the UN matter, okay, from a human rights perspective, every time we want to practice our UN resolution or United Nations Security Council, like we have 1960 and 2122, you know, all of these terms that came up to save the women in a conflict area and during the war. But the thing is, I'm saying, how can we do it if there is no peaceful area that we can negotiate their own rights? So the main thing, in a nutshell, we should start from the root itself. The political problem should be solved first by any political initiative. This had not happened, neither from the international fora. So my advice and my solidarity would say we should push the public via you, via conferences, via the hashtag, as the ladies before said, and via educating the people that this is their right, they should fight for it. We are fighting, but we are far away. I don't think we can do anything. But if a public in this time of century, everything had been changed in political fora via people, if you know what I mean, publicly. If we want to say no in our government, we would just go and strike peacefully. Yani, I think this is not a need to be repeated again and again. All of you should know. And my heartfelt emotion toward you guys in this day, and in particular in Kashmir with so much violence going on. May Allah hafiz and may Allah protect all of them. I'm not saying only Pakistan Zindabad, but humanity Zindabad. Okay, if you allow me, because I really need to finish something and I'm outside of Kuwait.
Thank you.